not how hangman works.
All right. All right, let's have a representative from, let's go to the solo section. Oh, Maggie. All right, Maggie, go.
P.
P.
Dang it. Thank you.
Alright!
Mississippi! Well, Mississippi!
A representative from the, let's do the rack section. No, actually the back row front ensemble. Okay. Back row front ensemble. Anybody in the back row? Choose amongst yourself. Fight, I don't know. Alright, Garrett Wetzig. Yes. A!
I like to do a bow on the
Alright, let's have a representative from the marimba section, the front row.
The word, the last one from Marcella, it's happiness. We know that.
Happiness. Yeah. Alright, that's correct.
Well, then you gotta put it all
the
wait, you
spelled it wrong.
No, you forfeited that right when you guessed a whole word.
Oh my god, Ava, you wasted it.
It's Marcella, it's Marcella.
What? Alright, did we do symbols already?
Yeah.
Yes, we did. Front row. Electronics.
I can already. Okay, so if we're doing that,
Riley
the second word is the.
Huh?
The second word is the.
The second word is the. Okay.
How'd you know that?
What?
So by the something something happiness. Okay, wait.
I know it.
She knows
right,
it.
If
she
you
knows
know it.
It.
Go ahead and discuss among your neighbors, and then we'll
all start happiness.
I know.
Why?
I know.
She knows it. She knows it.
Just.
All right. Let's take it.
Please.
Have any basses yet? All right. Baseline. You can guess a word, one word, or a letter. Gerard. Yes. Z.
No.
One from the parents. One from a word or a letter.
Please.
Parents.
Mr. Announcer. R.
Okay. That's yes. Please.
Oh,
please.
Know.
Please.
She knows. Please.
What about? Is there any alumni here? Let's see what.
Zach, there's only Zach.
We have a snare line yet?
No.
Oh, it's alright. Okay. All right. Let's do snare line. Yo.
Q.
Q. All right. I draw all the.
Really?
All right. Quads.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, but we. If you did the word, you have to guess the letter. So no one said T yet.
Oh my god.
Marcella is like,
who has not gone yet?
Marcella hasn't.
Alright. Discuss amongst yourselves.
We already know!
We already know!
Marcella.
Alright. Now I just want to say it.
What is it?
3, 2, 1.
And can you just start by introducing yourself and what you do with the Bridgeland Percussion Ensemble?
Yeah, so my name is Chris Nguyen. I am the percussion director at Bridgeland High School, and I'm just in charge of everything percussion from 6 to 12 at Sires Middle School and Bridgeland, and then sometimes Smith Middle School as well.
Hey, so I'm Joel McAda. I'm the assistant percussion director here at Bridgeland. I'm starting my third year here right now.
I was originally a trombone player back in middle school and then joined the drumline shortly in high school, 9th and 10th grade. Then I actually moved, I grew up in Mississippi, and then I moved to Texas, ended up in the Sioux Falls marching band. Where I played in the drumline as well, snare drummer my junior and senior year. Then I graduated and went on to march IPT, my senior year of high school, which is an indoor group. So that's where I met Joel McAda.
I actually, Mr. Nguyen and I marched together back in the day. We did indoor, 10 years ago. It was 2012, we marched together. So we've been really good friends for a long time, and he was trying to get me to come out to Bridgeland several years ago, and I was a little hesitant. I don't know, I'm kind of a creature of habit. Like I was just settled down. I didn't really want to move anywhere, but then the opportunity just, it was too great to pass up. So then I came out here, and it's been rock and roll ever since.
After IPT, the indoor stuff, I went on to March Oregon Crusaders 2012, where we won the open class DCI championships, which was fun. This was before they went to world class, and again, they're no longer around. After that, I ended up auditioning for my dream corps, which was the 2013 Phantom Regiment, and I made it, which was great. Had the summer of my life. And so that kind of ended my DCI career. I was ready to be done. Because at the time, I just got into nursing school in 2014, and I wanted to focus all in on school, and I did finish out my nursing degree. So I was done with the marching arts during that time, was kind of done with band and ready to move on. And at that time, I was teaching at a school called Bryan High School, just for fun, honestly for free. And it just changed my life forever, to the point where I think I wanted to give the music education thing a try. So I worked as a nurse as long as I could to keep my bonus. I wanted to quit right away so I didn't have to pay off my big bonus, the signing bonus that I received. So I did work 6 months and immediately auditioned for the University of Texas and San Houston State University. Ended up going to San Houston State University because of financial reasons, which was worked out really well. During that time, I was recruited and brought out of retirement to march the inaugural season, the opening season of Monarch 2015. That's when Monarch started, and I was heavily convinced to go march again. So I got myself back together and picked up a snare drum and did 2015. And then after that, great season, run by some great people who are still there. I was totally done. And that's when Monarch was open class, made open class finals for the first time. So I went back and focused on my teaching skills around the area, in the Conroe ISD area, and even in Cypher ISD, and just everywhere I could to teach. Stayed with Brian as well. And then in 2017, when Monarch made the jump to world class, I was somehow, like, it worked out with a clause that somehow I was able to march. And I was like, cool, like, I need front ensemble experience. So I signed up to audition for Marimba. And next thing you know, I was put on the snare line. So I was a super age out. I think someone told me this, I was the oldest member at WGI finals. And that was the year Monarch made finals for the first time, 2017. And because of my age, I was 23 at the time. I was the oldest member, like literally, but the oldest member on the floor at WGI, which was interesting. So I finished college and then opened Pato High School in Katy, Texas. And then I was recruited to go to Bridgeland, which just opened across the street. And I've been there ever since.
My last couple years as a marching member, I was teaching out in Fort Bend at Travis High School and doing like a little concert percussion program there. And then that's really where I like found my love for front ensemble. Was we were such a small group, and I was so busy doing indoor drumline myself that I didn't have the means to create like a full indoor program at my first school. So I did concert indoor, but treated it kind of like front ensemble. So it was just as regimented and like technique focused and that kind of idiom. And fell in love with that instantly and was like, dude, what am I doing with this snare drum business? And I just kind of like converted myself to front ensemble world at that point.
In the Pursuit of Happiness was a show that I definitely, it was something that I felt passionate about for the students to really latch onto. And so I had to really think about what the Bridgeland percussion students specifically were going through.
I'm Nick Ulanday. I am a snare drummer. I was on the snare line this past year, and I was a senior, so I just graduated.
So my name's William Olivo. I was a senior this past year, and I played quads. I was a quad section leader.
I'm Karsten Heinrich. I played marimba last year for indoor, and I was a senior.
Well, hello. My name is Ava Thomas. I was in 10th grade during the indoor show, and I play marimba.
I'm Grant Roberts. I play bass too, still do, and I'm going to be a senior.
So back when I was in fifth grade, thinking about what activity I was going to get into, My older brother had done band, but it was kind of a bad experience for him. He played clarinet, but he wanted to be a saxophone, you know. But my mom really encouraged me to do band and just try it out. And I thought, well, percussion seems like the most fun out of all of them. So that's how I got into it. And as I got older and progressed through middle school band and then into high school band, I enjoyed it enough to really stick with it for the whole time.
As a little kid, I always wanted to follow in my brother's footsteps. I mean, we've always had a really close relationship, and it was something that we could connect on. And I've played piano since I was a little kid, and so it kind of just felt like a really natural way to continue this love for music that I've had. And so I just really enjoyed having a way to, you know, follow with my brother and just do something that's looked so cool and so fun ever since I was a 10-year-old kid.
I was introduced to the rock band like a long time ago. I was really small, like 5 or 6, maybe 7, I don't know, a long time ago. But I really enjoyed playing the drums on rock bands, so that's kind of what got me into percussion in the first place. But obviously, marimba is not quite where I thought I was going to end up being all these years later, but it worked out well, so.
I wanted to play drum set in 6th grade, but then they didn't have drum set. And then I just got kind of stuck with it because I didn't want to do clarinet or anything else they had left.
Back in middle school, I wanted to do, I think I had theater as my first elective. I do have like a very open personality, so I chose theater at first. And I transferred schools, and theater had no more spots. So I chose band, and out of all the instruments, I could only see myself like doing percussion, really, because I wasn't really interested in anything else. Drumming's cool, yeah.
In the Pursuit of Happiness was a show that I definitely, it was something that I felt passionate about for the students to really latch onto. And so I had to really think about what the Bridgeland percussion students specifically were going through, you know, and their personalities, and what can we do to make sure the students have an understanding of like, oh, this show is really about them. And so something that I've noticed specifically at Bridgeland High School is that academically, it's very competitive. And at some point it's very strenuous to the point where I feel like the students I put into a situation to where they no longer can be themselves. By the time I think we designed the show, I was at Bridgeland for 4 years. I really gotten to know the clientele and the school culture and just the kids who were coming in and out of that program. You know, I noticed that like even some of the highest class ranked kids or the kids who are doing everything quote unquote right weren't really happy, you know, and that's from talking to the students and them expressing to me. It brought up some deep thoughts of like, as educators, what are we really doing here? You know, we're spraying all this on, and the goal was to create the best, you know, adolescents and young adults we can before they graduate with all these tools for success. But they're leaving here trying to make everyone happy. And at the end of the day, the person in the mirror isn't happy. Something that I try to do in my little section of Bridgeland High School was to like create an environment where the kids could be themselves, where, you know, they didn't have to kind of morph their personalities in a way to quote unquote fit in. In the Pursuit of Happiness was kind of a play on the lives I felt of the Bridgeland kids, to where they tried so hard to do everything right, to do everything that they're supposed to do, and to make this set of humans happy and to make their parents happy, make their community happy and rival their cousin and do all of that, that at the end of the day, they lost what makes them unique. You got to graduation, yay, you're top three, and was it all worth it?
There was a valedictorian speech from a graduating senior a few years ago. I stand before you tonight as the 2019 valedictorian. This time last year, I found out that I was in the running for this title. It was then that I decided I wanted it. So I worked hard for it, and I got it. And at our senior award ceremony, it felt so good when I heard my name announced with this title. It was so good for about 15 seconds. And I thought, that's it? This kid's speech was, what did I do this for? Why are we being pushed? I gave up my entire life to be this valedictorian, and like, it's not gonna matter later. Like, why? What did I trade to get this?
it's more about the journey than the end destination. It's more about like, what did you learn in the past 4 years of high school than being valedictorian.
I mean, I remember just that was the first indoor competition we were going into since spring of 2020, before everything got shut down. It was an entirely different group, save for a few members, including Nick and myself. We weren't really sure what to expect. This is our first time performing in that environment in a long time. So I think there was an excitement in the air, but also like nervous energy.
It felt very unreal. We'd only been really practicing in January. That was really our first full month of doing stuff. It felt like, oh no, like we're out of time. Like, you know, it's like we have to put this together and put it in front of people and judges. And
it kind of felt very slammed together, and we were really pushing to get it learned in the first place. It was sort of a scramble at the first competition.
And, you know, besides just the returning members not having done it in a while, that group was full of freshmen and sophomores who this is going to be their first experience with an indoor competition ever.
Especially with such a young group, my goal was to make sure competitively that the show made sense and that it read well. Read more than well. It read to where, you know, we were going to be put into a class that was pretty advanced for what on paper we were supposed to be.
I
Me and Chris were both kind of like, should we go to open class? Like, should we try? And then we were just like, our whole idea behind being educators is that we're trying to push our students to the maximum of their own capabilities. And who are we to write them off?
Getting second was like, whoa, we did that. I think everyone was just really proud of how far we had come in that first, just for the first competition.
I really didn't care about the results, but I felt like it was a chance for us to kind of keep going and moving forward, going up to open class.
It made everyone more driven and driven to make the show better. It was a push, a real good push that we needed.
If a panel of judges say, hey, y'all are ready to go up to a bigger class, then I think it's kind of unfair for us to be like, no, but wait. We don't think we're ready yet. Like, the world thought we were ready to move up.
And the kids knew, like, going to open class meant, like, things had to change rehearsal-wise, you know, so.
Yeah, so that first competition at Klein Collins, we really weren't sure to expect placement-wise, just because it was our first competition in a new class.
My goal going into that contest was literally, and my goal for every contest, is just to have an accurate representation of where we're at.
It was really exciting for us to place the way that we did, especially our first time in this classification.
That was WGI Houston. It was a big event competing at WGI. I remember a shaky performance in the morning just because I think everyone was tired. We had an early morning performance.
I remember the morning performance was very lackluster. It was blah.
We get to prelims and then everyone tried to turn it up their effort level, like even the younger kids, okay, now we're at a competition, now I'm gonna try. And because of that, the show was not good. And we had a long talk, you know, after the results came out, which was super favorable.
I think we can all agree that the performance today was not what we liked. We've been here before. We just, at some point, the design can only take you so far. And after next Tuesday, when we complete the show, we hand the baton to you. What are you going to do? Are you going to run? Are you going to walk? Are you going to fall and not get up? I think you guys should be proud of, obviously, the placement. Of the hard work that have gotten us here. I also think you should realize we have another shot tonight to kind of change that. Instead of like trying to win the judges over, how about you win the crowd over? How about you win the next little one who wants to be the next Bennett, or the next Maggie, or the next Marcella, or the next Jose? Because I was that 20 years ago. And most importantly, can you look yourself in the mirror tonight and be like, I was proud of myself today.
You know, we got second. You know, I was still disappointed with like, okay, like, something is not right. If you're going to do this, everybody has to try. You know, it couldn't be just the leaders or the older members or the people who really liked it. It had to be every single person. You know, in every movie, there's a part where the main character or the main team struggles and everyone's annoyed or really angst at each other. And this was our part of the movie where everybody was just frustrated, you know? And then, like every part of any Disney movie, there was a realization of like, let's get back on our feet and let's do this the right way.
It's a stickle spear face.
Oh, I like it.
Where it ends right now, the field is going to change, which is basically an excuse to be able to have like,
oh yeah, babe.
Hey, Chris, they're going to call you one by one.
It's a letter I.
Like you get on the bus and you see like my best friend in the whole world, like, hey, Parker. And I pull out my backpack, and there's a binder full of Pokemon cards, and it's like, shit's about to get real. You know, like, here's my holographics, here's my this, that's my letter H. So they're all here.
Yeah, well, I like.
Oh, that's more like, well, watch this. Like, hey guys, like, I'm.
So after a 45-minute nap or a meditation session, or I even think some of the kids started doing the pacer test. It was really weird. We had one of my favorite rehearsals I've ever had at Bridgeland. We had a really positive rehearsal where everyone tried, no matter how silly that seemed, especially the younger members, we did. I felt like we upgraded a car, but it was dirty. I think the analogy of if we were driving a car from the 90s, a Toyota Corolla from the 90s, and it was in pristine condition, I felt like we upgraded to like a Ferrari that had mud all over it. And so yes, we were dirty, but the engine itself was better. And the kids at WGA Finals had the performance of a lifetime.
After our practice at Klein Collins later that afternoon, I feel like we all really bonded as a family. I feel like the energy for the night performance was just so much higher, and everyone was performing at a higher level. And I feel like that's when we finally got our like push, like, you know, we're competing in open class, let's compete, let's perform our show for the crowd.
Good morning. It's currently like 4:50. One second. I'm not gonna lie, I'm pretty tired, but it's competition day.
Let's do it!
I'm gonna vlog myself driving to Bridgeland High School. March 26th, we're going to Pasadena Memorial today. Boo Zach, can't make it. Can't record, but that's okay. Hey, me again. I'm still driving to school. I was thinking about the question we were talking about yesterday during our stretch block. What's better on pasta, white sauces or red sauces? Nah, me, I'm personally a white sauce fan. I love that, you know, like fettuccine alfredo. That stuff is so good. But what does everyone else prefer? I wonder what the majority prefers. Compose a comment below and then put the EMC thing. Listen to this song, Walking by Denzel Curry. It's good. Alright, I'm back. Still driving to school. I'm not as tired anymore. I drank some coffee. I feel okay. You know? Feel okay. Today's morning rehearsal is gonna go great. Yesterday's rehearsal went really well. We had V. Willie Veenstra and Mr. Zamparelli both came out. Willie Veenstra, you know the guy, the drum major salute guy? Blue coats? And Luke Zamparelli. What? The Monarch guy? No way. Alright. So, here, I'm exiting, and I'm about to turn to get to Bridgeland. Who's excited? Woo, me. Is that Kevin? No, I don't know who that is, but they just ran the red light because they were behind me. Update, that driver was Kevin. Criminal. We have arrived at the school. Charlie Burke.
It is 5 in the morning.
It's 7 in the morning. It's 7 in the morning.
Are you tired?
A little bit. I got home from the girls' soccer game.
Uh-huh.
At 11:30.
Oh, damn. Ooh, what you drinking this morning?
Blue Raz.
Blue Bang. Raz Bang? Oh. I'm not personally a Bang fan. It's alright. It's alright.
Recording.
Okay. Zach can't make it today, so everyone's
good morning, everybody. Get out here at the school, 5 a.m. Drums in the gym. You know, it's your boy.
Like and subscribe. You're right. Good morning, everybody. How's everyone feeling? How are you feeling this morning, Maggie?
I feel great today.
Great? That's great to hear. Damn. Here's my uniform. Grabbing my shoes and my knee pads. My knee pads are pretty much paper thin now. Too much kneeling. Good morning, everyone. Everyone say hello.
Hi.
Whoa! Censor that. Censor that, Zach. We're all changed. Check it.
Good morning.
check it. Oh, shirt, pants. Ooh.
Hey, Lucas, say hey.
Hello.
This is Marcella. She just.
So we go at this door. We're gonna walk this way. Walk with me and Grant to the gym. And George. George is recording too. No way.
Triple vlog.
Dude, Zach's gonna have three angles of this. So why is there a tenor case here? There's just one in the middle of the hallway. There he is. Mr. William Olivo. How are you feeling today? Hey.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
Here we go. Going into the gym. Wow. Bridgeland High School gym. What? All of our stuff's already in here? Yeah, we had rehearsal last night. Three different angles of Parker McInnes. Zach, cut to Grant's angle.
Hi, guys.
Now cut to my angle.
Hi, guys.
Now cut to George's angle. So, Parker, three angles of Parker McInnes. Oh, he's moving with the GoPro, no way! Here's Lucas. All right, we're about to pull this thing. What did you find?
I found it on my drum.
Here's my drum, putting it on now. And now, we attempt to hit a shot. Is it gonna be a fail? There we go. Hold this for a second, Jose.
No way.
Now it's time to pull the floor. Marcella, wake up. Nightmare. Wake up, Marcella. Let's pull the floor. Four pulling montage. Time to set up the props. Grant Johnson, you're here.
Yeah, hello.
This is a big prop.
So today, we're asking Maggie to prom.
Aww. Grant and Maggie love arc.
It's gonna be great.
Jake, can you tell me what you're stretching in this position?
I forgot what it's called, but it feels...
Now he's getting abused. Let's get some shots of this.
Nice hip work, man.
Nice action shots.
I need a montage.
Oh, yeah.
How are you feeling now, Marcella? Better? Still tired?
Okay.
Inserting! Shoot, I think I did it wrong.
Oh, man.
Oh, full insertion of the stairs. There we go. Sweet.
Let's see what time it's not recording.
Got him. We got Hello Panda chocolate. Ooh. Yeah. Oreos. Goldfish. Oh, my favorite. Pringle. I got good.
Something else happened in the BJ bathroom.
Yeah, pay for our food at BJ's. Maggie, you literally owe us. Thank you. Try to focus on the people standing next to you. Think about how much these people mean to you. Think about the bonds we've made over the past 4 months, 4 or 5 months. It's been a very special season. Very special. I am extremely proud of every single one of you. Y'all mean a lot to me, and I have full confidence in every single person here. You can not only do well for yourself, but you are going to inspire so many people in the stands tonight. You're gonna change lives, and that's our whole goal, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wouldn't want to do this with anyone else. Y'all mean the world to me. Once in here, once in there. Let's throw down, yeah?
Yeah!
Proud of you. I just want to say thank you for everything, and I hope that you guys enjoy the run here. Whether you're an Aggie, a future Aggie, or not an Aggie ever, I hope you enjoy it. Thank you so much for the journey, and I hope we smack down tonight.
Alright, I got one more thing to say. It has been an honor and a pleasure to lead every single one of you this year. And it's been so great to see everybody grow and the paths you've all gone on. But it's time to come together as one and kill this show together. We can do it. Y'all know what time it is?
Performing their program in the pursuit of happiness.
was where it lie. There is no need to fear or cry. Happiness will always be inside.
That was the final nail in the coffin that the season was a success. And of course, like when that happened, we didn't know what competitively we were going to place, and nor did we care. The season was done, you know, and that's what I profess to the kids. Like they walked out of the floor with a season and a performance, which is rare, that they were proud of. And at the end of the day, all they cared about was celebrating it with each other. Me and Mr. Kata both and the rest of the staff are just like this. This is why we do this, you know, and that's, again, the kids understood it was over, you know, and anything after that was just a postlude celebratory effect. Even if we got in last, you know, we would have laughed about it and moved on. It's the reason why I chose to be a music educator. It's the reason why I took a pay cut for being a nurse. It was a moment like that felt like I won the lottery.
Rave, it's a video. Where's your rave gear, Carlton?
My rave gear?
Yeah.
Hey, Will.
You should do. You should, like, get, can I have this?
I was like, I know this from somewhere.
No, I'm like,
run a retreat. That's a lot of people.
Retreat was one of the most fun moments of the indoor season this year. You know, being out there with all these different groups, other percussionists, you know, getting along with like making friends with other groups. Retreat's a really fun experience.
Just like a whirlwind of emotions. We were really ready to just see the culmination of all our work and all our progress from the whole season just come together in that last performance. It really showed us that we could have a run that we were really proud of at the end of all of it. And I think that's what made all of us the most happy about it.
It's just a fantastic culmination to a wildly emotional season. What moves me and makes me emotional is the recognition of those kids' work.
7.925, High.
Seeing them come off the floor and being like teary and like loving each other and loving creating stuff was the coolest part of the whole season.
That is almost first. Today was a really exciting and fun day, and it's gonna be even more fun. Sorry, that was weird. Even more fun because we're gonna go to Bucky's, and we like to call it Bussies, and that's what's fun about Bussies.
Why is Bussies so funny?
So let me tell you why Bussies is funny.
You were joking. All right, I know.
Y'all have a good one. Yeah, so it's close.
We didn't get last. Very happy. Sounds like a dub to me. We could have got last, but didn't.
I definitely feel very happy now. Yeah, that's it.
That's all.
No, don't play the clown now.
Is that why Tyler?
Okay, so let's
start.
Thank you again. Thank you to our parents and Rudy crew.
Thank you. Think about how no shows would have worked without those humans. Like from a logistics standpoint, with like parents taking care of you, to the roadies making sure that your entire set got on the floor. Like it literally takes a village to make Pajama Band work. So like, give it up for them.
Okay, so obviously, kind of a fairy tale ending. And I hope everyone is happy with how it ended. And I hope you had a wonderful day. I hope you had memories that you'll never forget. And, you know, like you said, it's enough said about the season. I think it was special to everybody. And not to get cheesy, but I truly, truly hope you have internalized what true happiness is, right? Like you can't just have some arbitrary thing and be affected by what's around you. You can only control yourself. And you truly believe in yourself. I truly believe that you can be happy. And please take that message going forward, especially new seniors in life. You're gonna have things that you cannot control. But you can always control how you feel with the person in the mirror.
Genius, don't you walk out those doors and not give me a hug? Oh my
God! You know, dude, someone said race line and I started thinking about the race line. Oh, and I was like,
the race
line. I started thinking about the race line. That's when the waterworks came out.
Yeah.
Like, oh man.
All I know is I'm staying in band, right?
It was worth it, wasn't it?
Those kids have taught us a lot about what life is really about. And it ain't about a plastic piece of trophy, you know? It's about what's real. And that moment was what was real.
The show talks about being in the pursuit of happiness and like what brings us joy. What makes you happy?
Creating music. Literally, my whole life revolves around making music with other humans. Something about the creation of something intangible that you can't really even describe it when you just know that the other person is feeling what you're feeling, not just feeling something at the same time as you, but they are experiencing the same experience that you are experiencing right then. That's some magic stuff. And that's like my whole life. That's everything. It's just here with the kids making music, or I'm making music on my own. It's the things that bring me happiness are creating sounds with other humans. It's my whole life, baby.
Connection with people around me does, certainly through this indoor season, forming a bond with everybody as we struggle together towards a common goal. And, you know, not just in indoor, in all aspects of my life. I just love finding connections with people and making relationships based on common experiences.
I think what brings me happiness is having good relationships with the people around me. I don't necessarily like the saying that you shouldn't find happiness from other people, because for me personally, when I have support from other people, it just allows me to feel like I belong. And I think belonging is a big part of being happy, where you feel like you can be a part of something that's bigger than yourself. And that's exactly what the entire season was. It was not just being me, my own marimba player, it was being a part of an entire ensemble. And I don't think there's something that can give you as much happiness as feeling like you belong and feel like you're wanted and listened to. That is unmatched for me.
This indoor season, I won't remember it for the performances, to be honest. Like, that's one part of it, but all the little like moments with my friends. Honestly, what makes me happy was the family we had and like the friendships we made. Like, those are what's most important to me about that whole indoor season.
I felt like
this whole year, like, I don't know if I could have made it without band in general, really. And I could say that for all 4 years and all 7 years that I've been a part of band, especially this last year, man, like, honestly, was the best year that I've ever had in my life. And the year before was rough with pandemic and, you know, all of what came with that junior year. And it just felt like nothing was stopping us from being together as a bunch of band and percussion weirdos again, you know. And getting up in the morning for band camp was never the easiest thing for me, but I felt like this last year, like, I was excited to get up in the morning and just to have fun and be with them. It was just a different experience this year, and that's it's been happy.
Young adults who are a lot smarter and brighter than they think, realizing the potential that they have, you know, which was why I became a teacher. I like humans. It's why I travel so much. What makes me happy is understanding what makes everybody else happy, and that I can be around those environments and get feed off of that. It makes me really happy when kids are okay with struggling and learn how to get up on their own feet. It makes me happy when adults do that, when they're struggling and they get up on their own feet. It makes me really happy when humans, and specifically as an educator, my students, they look themselves in the mirror and they're proud of themselves.
Hey guys, I hope you just enjoyed what you just watched. If you did, make sure you like and subscribe. Tweet me, follow me on Instagram. I don't know, whatever else you want to do. Stay safe out there, and I hope everyone stays awesome. Have a good one.